And the mouth of madness. Yours to deliver, Trent.
What?
I'll be joining my new publishers now. You take the manuscript back to the world for me. That's what you do.
What I do?
You are what I write. Like this town. It wasn't here before I wrote it. And neither were you.
No. I know what's real. I know what I am. Nobody pulls my strings.
Did you think my agent attacked you by accident? He read about you, in there. He knew you'd bring it back and start the change, make what's happened here happen everywhere. He tried to stop you.
I'm not a piece of fiction.
I think therefore you are. Read it if you don't believe me. See what I have in store for you.
Know what I am?
Go back. Your world lies beyond that passage. Go now. I can't hold them back any longer.
Trent stood at the edge of the rip, stared into the illimitable gulf of the unknown, the Stygian world yawning blackly beyond. Trent's eyes refused to close. He did not shriek, but the hideous, unholy abominations shrieked for him, as in the same second he saw them spill and tumble upward, out of an enormous carrion black pit, choked with the gleaming white bones of countless unhallowed centuries. He began to back away from the rip as the army of unspeakable figures, twilit by the glow from the bottomless pit, came pouring at him toward our world.